those of you who are already tuned in, I'm going to do a little quick intro as we wait for everyone to join us in this practice. This is Shangri-La Hot Yoga, for those of you who are not familiar. And my name is Melissa, and I'll be teaching you this evening. I am a teacher at the studio as well as the studio manager. Maybe you've joined me in class before, maybe you're new to your practice with us. I pride myself in making my classes all levels, so we're going to be doing a 45-minute power flow. Don't let the power name make you shy away from this, right? It's powerful in the way that we're going to move fast. We're going to work our core a lot just because we are only moving for 45 minutes, so we definitely want to get ourselves moving and working here, right? So make sure to go at your own pace, do your own practice. If you need to take breaks at any point, please do so. Drink water. And if you don't have props at your house, you can, if you don't have a block or anything, you can always take a stack of books, maybe some blankets, a water bottle, if you ever need any support as well. Also, before we begin, I am wearing a shirt. It's just skin colored. I didn't realize it would not translate well to the camera. All right. Well, give it a couple minutes. So hopefully everyone can be joining in, and if not, they can join us over time and just hop in whenever they would like to. All right. Hopefully you can hear me okay here. We're gonna get started in child's pose. If you're unfamiliar to child's pose, we're gonna bring our big toes to touch and our knees are gonna come out wide. If it's not comfortable to have the knees out wide, you can always bring the knees together to touch. And then from here, reach the hands nice and long in front of you. Lengthen out the spine. Allow the head to soften towards the ground. And you can maybe start with some rocks back and forth. You can allow the head to shake back and forth, giving your forehead a little massage. And allow the hips to settle back towards the heels, stretching out through the hips. And then just settle into your mat for a couple breaths here as we begin. Feeling your natural breath. Just taking a second to scan the body. Just noticing how you're feeling today. What is it that you need from your practice? Making sure that you modify. I'll be showing plenty of options for those of you who have a more advanced practice. You can always take these postures a little bit further if it feels good to you. And then starting here with a deep breath in through the nose, fill up all the way. Open the mouth, clear it out. Even bigger breath in. Let it go. Last full inhale. Release. From here, you can close the lips. Start to breathe in and out through the nose. Maybe you find a slight constriction to the back of your throat if you're familiar with your Ujjayi breath. And then just take a couple here to cultivate. So make each breath a little bit longer, a little bit deeper than the last one. Breath in, come up to a tabletop. So stack the shoulders above the wrists and the hips above the knees. We're going to find a stable table. That means pulling the navel in towards the spine to find a flat back. Grip the ground and just slightly press away to strengthen your shoulders. Inhale, lower the belly, open the chest. Exhale, press away around the spine. Inhale, cow. Exhale, cat. Two more times, big breath in. Let it go. Inhale, broaden the chest. Exhale, curl the spine. Next breath in, come back to your neutral spine, your stable table. From here, we're gonna root down through our left hand. We're gonna take the right hand to the back of our head. So we're gonna work our core here. Just hand is nice and light. With an inhale, you're gonna open that elbow up, press away from the ground, open the chest. And then an exhale, you're gonna take the elbow over towards your other arm and tap here. Pull the navel in, engage your core. Inhale, sweep back up. Exhale, curl in. Inhale, open. Exhale, twist. One more time, big breath in. Let it out. Good, inhale, come back up. Okay, exhale, hand comes back underneath you, come back to your tabletop, switching sides, left hand comes to the back of the head. Big breath in, open up. Breath out, curl it towards the other arm. Pause, pull that navel in, tight core. Inhale, open. Exhale, twist. Two more times, inhale, lift. Exhale, close. Last one, inhale. Exhale. Good, big breath in to lift up. Breath out, hand comes back underneath you. Moving on, tuck your toes, full breath in. Breath out, start to lift the hips high to your first downward facing dog. And this is our first down dog, so find some movement here. That means bending into one knee, and then the other, pedaling it out. You can shake the head, yes, and no. The neck is feeling tight, you wanna take movement there. Just kind of noticing what feels tight in your body, and then sending the movement to that part. And when you're ready, settle into stillness. Press into the fingertips, try to root through the knuckle of the pointer finger. Keep a soft bend in the knees here to find more length in your low back. And then press the heels towards the ground, stretch through the backside of your legs. Allow the head to hang heavy, finding a nice long neck. Inhale, bend the knees, look forward towards the top of the mat. Exhale, start to step the feet up to your forward fold. You can have feet out at hips width apart, or big toes can touch, whichever feels better for you. Inhale, halfway lift, hands meet shins or thighs. Exhale, fold forward, pausing here. Bend the knees generously. Hands grab opposite elbows for ragdoll. From here, start to sway back and forth, finding length in the spine. Trying to reach the crown of the head towards the ground. This should feel really good on the low back. If you've been sitting a lot, staying a lot throughout your day, putting a lot of pressure on the spine. And we'll meet back at center, hands released down. Keep a little bend in the knees, chin to chest. Inhale, slowly lift the spine up to standing, feeling every single vertebra as you rise. Shoulders come back and together, palms face forward. Coming to our mountain pose. Lift the kneecaps up to engage the quads. Pull the belly button in, trying to engage the core. And then press the fingertips down towards the ground. Inhale, sweep the hands up high mountain. Exhale, interlace the hands, bring them behind the head. Press the head into the hands, open up the chest, full breath in. Breath out, pull the chin to the chest, pull the elbows together, curl the spine, pull the navel in tight. We're gonna do that breath to movement, inhale, open up. Exhale, curl. Last one, inhale. Exhale. Good, this time, inhale, open up, reach the hands high. Exhale, bend the knees, sit the hips low, hands come to heart for chair pose. So we're gonna sink the weight back into our heels and out of our toes. So you can lift your toes up a little bit and wiggle them. And then pull the ribs in towards each other. So nice strong core, it's gonna help us elongate our low back. Roll the shoulders back and together. And then just sink a little bit lower, really challenge yourself here. Two more breaths, find a new edge with every breath out. Last one. Settle in. Good, one more inhale. Exhale, fold forward. Keep a bend in your knees here as you fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. From this forward fold, plant the palms onto the mat. Inhale, step back to your first high plank. With this first high plank, we're gonna lower our knees down. So we're just gonna find a little supported plank here. And every time you go through chaturanga, you're more than welcome to take your knees. You do not have to do a full chaturanga. Pull the navel in, squeeze the glutes, and then press away, find that strength in the upper body. Full breath in, shift slightly forward. Breath out, bend elbows, hug them in and lower halfway down. We're gonna do some push-ups here. Inhale, press away, lift up plank. Exhale, lower. Inhale, rise up. This time, exhale, bend the elbows, hug them in, and lower all the way down. Untuck the toes. Point the toes to the back of the room. Root the feet down. Inhale, lift the chest up, little baby cobra. So we're just barely lifting the chest. Hands are nice and light. Gaze is down at the ground. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, lower it down. Inhale, rise up. Maybe come a little bit higher in that baby cobra. Hands are nice and light. Maybe you lift them up for a little bit more challenge. Make sure that you're pointing those toes. Maybe the kneecaps slightly lift. Big breath in. Breath out, soften down. We're going to do one more back bend. You choose baby or full cobra. Inhale, lift up. Maybe pause at baby. Or if you're feeling ready, you're going to straighten those arms, come to that full cobra. Keep a soft bend here. So just notice when you do this, you're going to hunch the shoulders up to the ears. So bend the elbows, roll the shoulders back in together. One more breath in. Breath out, lower all the way down. From here, tuck the toes. Fire up the thighs. You can use the knees for support here if you need to. Press into the palms. Inhale, come up to your high plank. One long line to your plank. Exhale, down dog. We're going to go through that breath to movement. So just listen carefully. We're going to get that heart rate going. Inhale, bend the knees, look forward. Exhale, knee to the top of the mat. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold. One big movement. Inhale, root to rise, high mountain. Exhale, hands interlace behind the head. Pause with the breath in. Breath out, curl in. Chest, chin to chest. Inhale, open up. Two more times. Exhale, close. Inhale, broaden. Exhale, curl. Inhale, open up. Reach the hands high. Exhale, hands to heart chair. Full breath in here. Breath out, fold forward. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Pause. We're preparing for our first chaturanga. Plant the palms. Inhale, step back to high plank. Knees can lower down just like with that first round. Inhale, shift slightly forward. Exhale, bend the elbows, hug them in, lower half or all the way. Inhale, open up the chest, cobra or upward facing dog. Exhale, lift the hips high, downward facing dog. Remember, you can skip chaturangas at any point, or you can modify them for your practice. Inhale, bend, look forward. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, melt. Inhale, sweep high. Exhale, hands interlace. Big breath in here. Breath out, close the elbows together. Inhale, open. Exhale, navel to spine. One more time, inhale. Exhale. Inhale, reach up high mountain. Exhale, chair. Inhale here. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, chaturanga of choice. Plant the palms, find your flow. You can always hop back for a little bit more. Inhale, broaden the chest. Exhale, lift the hips. Deep breath in here. Open up, clear it out. Working further from our downward facing dog. Inhale, right leg reaches high, three leg dog. Pause just for a moment. Try to point the pinky toe down towards the ground. And squeeze the glute to lift the heel a little bit higher. Deep breath in here. Breath out, take the knee in towards the chest. Tiger pose. You can bring the nose towards the feet for a little bit more challenge here. Inhale, reach back up. Exhale, step the foot forward between the hands, nice and gentle. Find your active lunge. Take a second. Make sure the knee is right above or slightly behind the ankle here. You can keep a soft bend in that back knee. Firm up through the inner thighs. Inhale, rise up, come to your high crescent. So like I said before, you can find that soft bend. It's gonna help you find more length in your low back here. Make sure you can lift up your toes, wiggle them a little bit. Pull the ribs in towards each other, engage the core. And then reach up, lengthen out of the hips, touch the ceiling. Full breath in here. With your breath out, interlace the hands behind the head. Inhale at center. With your exhale, you're going to take that right elbow over towards the right hip. So find a little side bend here. We're crunching into our obliques. Stay nice and firm through the thighs. Squeeze the glutes for stability in the hips. Inhale, rise back up. Reach up. Exhale, heel down. Open up to your warrior two. So in warrior two, our back foot is about 90 degrees. And our front toes are pointing towards the front of the room. Reach the arms out nice and wide. Try to open up the knee towards the pinky toe and spread the shoulders out. Reaching those fingertips towards opposite sides of the room. Settle in a little bit deeper to that front thigh. Challenge yourself. Good. Inhale, start to shift or reach towards the front of the room. Exhale, right arm comes to right thigh. Left arm reaches high, coming to our extended side angle. If you have another variation of this posture, you're more than welcome to take it. We're gonna use our obliques here, so we're gonna take that top hand, and we're gonna place it behind the head. And then press the head into the hand, open up the chest, and try to lift the arm a little bit away from the thigh. So just make sure that you're using your side core here. Roll the shoulders back in together, open up the chest, and then come a little bit deeper. We're here for two. Last big breath. Good, inhale. We're gonna reverse our warrior, try to keep that bend. Sweep the right hand back, lengthen through the right side body. If you need to, always come out of that lunge and then back in. Back hand is nice and light. We're not pressing down on the knee. Reach up a little bit more, big breath in. Breath out, hands come down, frame the foot. Inhale, step that foot back, find your high plank. Exhale, chaturanga, flow. Inhale, big chest. Exhale, hips back. Inhale, left heel up, three legs up. Flexing the foot, imagine you wanna press that heel and touch it to the back of the room. Big breath in. Breath out, knee to chest. Maybe you bring the nose towards the knee. We're rounding the spine here. Inhale, sweep it high. Exhale, step it through, nice and light. Back knee stays lifted. Adjust that stance to your own body. All right, from here, squeeze the glutes for stability. Inhale, power up. High crescent. We're gonna pause right here. We're gonna settle in. We're gonna feel that burn in that front thigh. Try to challenge yourself. Come a little bit deeper here. Reaching up, lengthening the spine, keeping that core nice and tight. Inhale. Exhale, hands come behind the head. Pause for a big breath in. With a breath out, take the left elbow over towards the hip. Find a little side body stretch. Also working those obliques here. Pull the left hip back, the right hip forward. Engage your hips, find your stability. Inhale, come back to center, reach up. Exhale, heel down, open up warrior two. Good, just finding our other side here. Try to press into the outer edge of your right foot. We wanna keep our back leg as engaged as our front. Reach the fingertips out. Come a little bit deeper into that thigh. Pressing the knee open. This is a hip opener here in our warrior two. So just try to open up those hips as much as possible. Inhale, extend forward. Exhale, left arm to thigh, and then right arm high. Extended side angle. If you find other variation, just making sure we're keeping our core engaged. We keep our chest nice and open. Take that top hand, place the hand behind the head, and then press the head back into the hand. Open up the chest. This arm is nice and light, so maybe you can just let it lift it away from the thigh, keeping that core engaged. Press that head back a little bit more. Two more big breaths. Don't let the breath get away from you. Last one. Inhale, reach the left hand back, reverse. Lengthen out. Try to keep that bend as much as possible. It's okay, so you take a second and then come back in. Reach up and then back. Making sure we're not crunching into our back side. Last inhale. Exhale, hands down. Inhale, step back, plank. Exhale, flow through. Remember, you can skip it if you need to and just meet us in down dog. Inhale, cobra upward. Exhale, downward dog. Full breath in here. Open the mat, clear that out. Just letting go of some of that heat. Next, we're gonna move through that a little bit faster. We're gonna go breath to movement. So this part's gonna be a lot of cardio. It's really gonna get our heart rate going, but that's kind of the point here, right? We wanna find some cardio here in our yoga. Going at your own pace. If you ever need to come to child's pose, please do so. From downward facing dog, inhale, right leg high. Exhale, knee to chest. Inhale, three leg dog. Exhale, low lunge. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, hands behind head. Pause with a big breath in. Breath out, right elbow down. Inhale, center, lengthen. Exhale, open up, warrior two. Inhale, extend. Exhale, side angle. Maybe hand comes behind head. Inhale, reverse that warrior. Keep the bend. Exhale, windmill the hands down, chaturanga or skip it. We all meet in our downward facing dog. Inhale, left leg up. Exhale, hug it in. Inhale, sweep it high. Exhale, step it forward. Inhale, reach. Exhale, interlace. Pause with the breath in. Breath out, left elbow down. Inhale, high crescent. Exhale, open up. Inhale, reach long. Exhale, extended side angle. Inhale, reverse, sweep it back. Exhale, plant the palms. Chaturanga or don't, we all mean our downward dog. We're gonna do that one more time on each side, all right? You got this, stay with me. Inhale, right foot up. Exhale, pull it in. Inhale, sweep it high. Exhale, step it forward. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, hands together. Big breath in. Breath out, right elbow down. Inhale, center. Exhale, open. Inhale, extend. Exhale, side angle. Inhale, sweep the right hand back. Exhale, plant the palms, flow through. Or just skip. Remember, you can just step the foot back and find your downward facing dog if you're feeling that way. Almost there, final side. Inhale, three leg dog, left foot. Exhale, knee to chest. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, step forward. Inhale, power high. Exhale, interlace. Big breath in. Breath out, left elbow down. Inhale, reach high. Exhale, open up. Inhale, extend. Exhale, side angle. Inhale, reverse. Exhale, chaturanga. We mean down dog. We're gonna clear out some of that heat here. Big breath in. Sigh it out. One more time. Big inhale. Clear it out. Inhale, bend the knees, look forward. Exhale, find your way to the top of the mat. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, hands to heart, pause right here. Couple of breaths. We're just gonna try to slow down the heart rate a little bit, get a little bit of that heat down, right? But we still wanna keep the heat up because we're still gonna keep falling. Big breath. So if you wanna let go of some of that, making sure that we're coming back to those open mouth exhales. If you wanna keep the heat, close the lips, come back to your Ujjayi. Few breaths in our mountain pose, three more. Last one. All right, open the eyes if you close them. Inhale, reach up high. Exhale, hands to heart. All right, we're gonna come into a little bit of balance here. So we're gonna start by rooting down into our left foot. Spread the toes out, keep a soft bend. Right knee is gonna lift up. Come to your one leg mountain pose. Keep the gaze at the ground. It's gonna help you feel the most supported here. We're gonna reach the hands up and then place the hands behind the head, interlace. Kind of sense of the theme here, right? You're keeping that chest nice and open. We're gonna take a breath in. And then with the breath out, we're just gonna slowly start to twist the body over towards that right leg. So we're into a little twist here, keeping the chest open, reaching those elbows out nice and wide. Flex the foot for more support. One more breath. With the breath in, come back to center. On the breath out, you're gonna take that right leg, you're gonna start to cross it over the left. Keep the hands interlaced. If that's okay for you, find your eagle legs. You can kickstand if you need to. This can help you feel support here, using the toes onto the ground. Hug the thighs in towards each other. Sink low like you're sitting into your chair. Deep breath in. And with the breath out, close the elbows together, bring the chin in towards the chest. We're gonna do it two more times. Inhale, open up. Exhale, curl. Last one, inhale. Exhale. Good, inhale, come back to center. And just shake it out, let it go. We're gonna do that on our other side. Take a second, that side might be kind of screaming a little bit. So any movements that you need in between. Switching sides, we're gonna root down through the right foot, hands start at heart center. Lift the left knee up, one leg mountain pose. Find your stability first. Gaze at the ground the entire time if you're feeling really wobbly. Reach the hands high. Interlace those hands behind the head. Pause in with a breath and reach up through the crown. Breath out, pull the navel in, start to twist over towards that left leg. We're just using our core here with our twists. Remember, gaze at the ground the entire time, especially if you're feeling wobbly. If you're super, super stable, you can always try to lift it up. One more breath. Try to keep the balance if you can. Come back to center. Left leg starts to cross over the right. You can use that kickstand for support to come to those eagle legs. So one thigh is gonna be right on top of the other. You're squeezing them in towards each other. Pull the navel in. Tight core is gonna make you feel more stable. Inhale here. Exhale, chin to chest. Pull those elbows together. Inhale, open up. Exhale, curl. One more, big breath in. Breath out. Inhale, open up and shake it out, let it go. All right, moving on, mountain pose, inhale, rise. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, chaturanga. We make our way to downward facing dog. That's where we'll all meet. All right, adding on to our flow. This will be our last main flow of our practice. Give us everything that you have. Inhale, right leg reaches high. Exhale, knee to chest. Inhale, sweep it high. Exhale, step it forward. Pausing right here, we're gonna take the left hand to either a block if you have one, or the ground. Inhale, right hand opens up, come into a low lunge twist. Pressing away. Now we're going to take that top hand to the back of the head. Press the head into the hand. Open up the chest, just like we did in our extended side angle. Placing the weight into the inside edge of that right foot. See if you can lift that back heel a little bit higher. For support, you're welcome to lower the knees down here. It's not have to be lifted. Full breath in. And then breath out, the hands are going to come back down to the mat. Good. From here, we're going to place the back heel down 90 degrees, finding our warrior two legs. Inhale, sweep it up. So back to our warrior two, we've been here before. Seems familiar. Inhale, reach out long. Exhale, extended side angle. So we're gonna build onto our extended side angle. Top hand comes to the back of the head. We're gonna add in a little bit of core. If you're feeling it, you're probably like, you're killing me here, so much core. Inhale, open up. Exhale, take the left elbow over toward that right leg. Inhale, sweep open. Exhale, curl. One more time. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, reach back up. Come back to the side angle. We're going to lift up to our warrior two. Straighten that front leg. So straighten that. You're probably like, oh my God, yes. We're starting to walk that back foot in just a little bit. So we just want a little bit of a shorter stance here. You're going to try to lift the kneecaps up. We want to keep our quads nice and strong. Reaching those arms out long. Inhale, press the hips back. Start to reach forward with that right hand. Exhale, back center of the right hand to the inner thigh, and left arm high to triangle pose or trikonasana. You can stay right here. If you feel like you have space, you're welcome to try to come down. But make sure if you're coming down, that if you start to collapse forward, that you lift back up. I want to keep the chest nice and open, making sure we're using our obliques here. All right, option to add on more core. If you want to, you can take that bottom hand, reach it forward. Maybe add on by taking the top hand, bicep alongside ear. Measure that you're holding something between the hands. You don't want it to drop. Maybe it's that really delicious plate of cookies. You're like, I really gotta eat these later. Or the burrito. And then that's my one, my choice. You don't want that burrito to drop. You really, really, really want to eat it. Pull those hands together. One more breath. Good. Inhale, rise back up. From here, we're gonna walk our heels in and our toes out, reaching towards the ceiling for our star. Deep breath in. Breath out, hands come to heart, come down to your goddess. So goddess, we're bending into this nice squat. We're pressing our knees open, right? Hands come to heart center. Maybe you sway back and forth, just find some movement. On this side, we're just gonna find our familiarity with our goddess. And on the other one, we're gonna add on. Just come a little bit deeper. Try to place that weight down, sink the hips down. One more breath. Good, inhale, rise up, star. Exhale, warrior two. Inhale, reverse the warrior. Exhale, palms come down. Inhale, high plank, flow through or meet in down dog. Remember, there's no expectation to do every single chaturanga. All right, final side here before we bring it down. Inhale, left foot up. Exhale, hug it in. Inhale, reach it high. Exhale, step forward. This time the right hand comes to block our mat. Inhale, left hand opens up. Always an option to place that knee down if you need support. Take the hand to the back of the head. Press the head into the hand. It's gonna help us use our obliques here. It's gonna help us open up our chest. Try to press away from the ground with the right hand, strengthen the shoulder. Pull the navel in, twist a little bit more. Last breath in. Another breath out, hand comes back down. If the knee is lowered, lift up. Lower the foot down 90. Inhale, sweep it up. Warrior two. Inhale, extend long. Exhale, side angle. Building on, hand behind the head. Full breath in here. Breath out, curl it in. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, twist. One more time. Inhale, open. Exhale, close. Good, inhale, reach that hand back up. Come up to your warrior two to straighten that front leg. Walk the back foot in just a little bit. Maybe just like one footprint. Reach those arms out long. If you want to touch the opposite side of the room. Inhale, press the hips back. Reach, 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 reach. Exhale, back side of left palm to inner thigh. Right arm up, triangle. Trikonasana. Keep the quads strong. Pull the arms apart. Maybe add it on. Reach the left arm forward. Right bicep alongside ear. You don't want that to drop, right? You really want to eat something good later. And you drop it on the floor. You never know. Keeping the navel in. Nice tight core. One more full breath. Good. With that inhale, we're going to rise back up to that. Lifting up. Whew, all right. Now I'm blanking on what I did after that.
Got it.
Oh, yeah, that's what I did. I have two helpers in the back here. All right. Inhale, reach up. Heels and toes out. Exhale, hands hard. Sink it down, goddess. All right. From here, we're going to have the hands behind the head. Familiar side here. Using our obliques, big breath in at center. Breath out, take the right elbow over towards that right thigh. Inhale, lengthen up. Exhale, left. Inhale, center. Exhale, right. Inhale, lift. Exhale, left. Good, this side. Inhale, come back to center. Reach the hands high, lengthen up. Exhale, warrior two. We're almost there. Inhale, reverse the warrior. Exhale, plant the palms. Chaturanga, final chaturanga if you want it. And we meet in our down dog. Cleansing breath in. Big breath out. Just see where we're at on time here for a second. See what else we can fit in. All right, we're gonna do a little bit of stretching here. From our downward facing dog, inhale, right leg reaches high. Working half pigeon if you're familiar with it. Exhale, knee comes behind the wrist. Soften the shin down onto the ground. Extend the left leg out nice and long here. Stay a second with the chest lifted. Try to squeeze the glutes and keep the hips nice and strong, right? We can sort of keep our hips engaged here and strengthen. And then when you feel like you're really stable, start to walk the hands forward. It can be into your sleeping pigeon. If you have a prop, you can take that prop underneath the right hip. If this is super uncomfortable for you and you're like, I can't do this posture because it hurts my knee, I have sensitive knees, I know it bothers me sometimes, you can just come onto your back. This is another great variation. Just reclining down, placing the right ankle over the left thigh, and just pressing into that right knee. So this is a reclined half pigeon. Just another version. There's lots of ways to make a practice what you need from it, right? Lots of different versions for every body. And there's never one ultimate way to look in a posture because we're all gonna look a little bit different. All of our bodies are completely different. The most important part is that we're trying to keep ourselves safe in these postures by engaging our muscles. So even in our pigeon, we're still engaging our hips because that's gonna help save our knee, So you want to try to soften through the upper body, but keep those hips nice and strong here, right? Couple more breaths here. Slowing it down a little bit. Big breath in. Clear it out. Last inhale. Let it go. Start to walk the hands back underneath the shoulders. We're gonna tuck the back toes and lift the knee up. Inhale, reach that right leg high and shake it out. So bend the knee, find some circles here. If you have your flip dog as part of your practice, you're more than welcome to come there here as well. Just trying to take some movement back into the joint. And then meeting in our downward facing dog. Inhale, left leg reaches high. Exhale, half pigeon on that side, so knee behind wrist, shin down. And the shin does not have to be parallel to the front of the mat, right? We can have a nice angle here, because that will feel better on a lot of our knees. Take a second with that chest lifted, making sure we're pulling those hips together, we're firming up through the inner thighs. And then once you find that stability, then we're gonna walk ourselves forward. And same variations on the other side. So maybe you grab a block, and you place it underneath the hip. That's if you have a lot of space here and you find that you're kind of leaning over to one side. You can come onto your back into your reclined half pigeon as well if you're feeling some pain in your knee. We never want to feel pain, right? You might be a little bit uncomfortable in postures. Maybe if we're holding something a long time, it gets a little bit uncomfortable. But if you ever feel pain, there's always another option, something else that you can find that works for your body. Pausing here. Taking those big breaths to slow down the heart rate. Three more. Last little breath in. Side out. Walking back up. Tucking the back toes, lifting the knee. Inhale, lift that left leg high. Bend the knee, shake it out. Maybe you flip the dog. And then meet in our last downward facing dog. You're probably like, oh my gosh, this felt like a 90 minute class. No, I'm just kidding. All right, last breath in. And then your breath out, soften the knees down. Hips come off to either side. Reach the legs long. Oh, we're gonna slow it down here. Well, not all the way. I can't promise I won't do one more round of core. Keep those legs long. We're gonna come into a forward fold here. So flex the toes towards the shin. You can have a soft bend in the knees here if you know you have really tight hamstrings. Inhale, reach the hands nice and high. Exhale, extend forward. And then your hands will come to shins, ankles, or feet. They do not have to be at the feet if you can't quite reach. And you can always bend the knees if you want to be able to use the feet here as a little bit more support. So kind of up to you, knees bend, knees straight, hands wherever you can reach. The most important part here is you want to keep our spine nice and long. So notice if you're rounding in, we don't want you rounding the spine. You want to keep it open and long. That means pulling the shoulders back. That means keeping the chin towards the chest, but not touching the chest. So chin is just slightly lifted away. Maybe you're looking forward with the eyes just to help to broaden your chest. And then finding a new edge with every exhale. Lengthening out the spine. Last breath. With your inhale, you're gonna slowly rise back up. All right, like I said, I can promise no more core. We are gonna use our core to come down to the ground. That's gonna be our last little bit of activity. So we're gonna come to our boat pose. You have options. You can keep the toes on the ground, the hands behind the thighs. You can lift the shins up parallel to the mat. From here, I'm gonna give you an option to either reach forward or for a little bit more interlaced hands behind the head. So just finding the activation like we have been for most of our class. Press the head into the hand, lift up through the crown of the head. Pull the navel in. Full breath in here. And then your breath out, start to lower down to that low boat. See if you can pause here. Inhale, see if you can lift up. Ooh, hard for me too. Exhale, I'm gonna lower it down. This time we're gonna pause right here. Start to flutter kick. We're 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, two, and one, release. Reach the arms long, reach the legs long, stretch out the core. Whew. Shake it out. Thank your body for everything it's done for you so far. It's probably worked pretty hard. Might be sweating, I know I am. And then from here, pull the knees into the chest. Start to find little circles with the knees, just massaging the low back into the ground. If you have a happy baby as part of your practice, you can grab the shins, ankles, or feet and pull the knees down for your happy baby. You don't have to grab the feet, but it's not quite accessible. Most important part is keeping the low back connected to the ground. And then just finding those movements once again. And then we'll meet back with the knees at center. Tee the arms out to the sides. So just reach both your arms out long. And then lower the knees over to the right. Coming to our supine twist. If you have a blanket nearby, you can place a blanket between the knees or underneath for support. Making sure your left shoulder is connected to the ground here. And we're slowing it all down. So give yourself permission to slow down the heart rate and the breath. And the mind. Maybe even close the eyes at this point. Keep the eyes closed until the end of your practice. That just helps you prepare yourself for the final rest. Pause at center for a moment, maybe squeeze them in, neutralize the spine. And then reach the arms back out long. Lower both the knees over to the left. Finding your supine twist on your opposite side. Reaching for the right arm, rooting that right shoulder down. You can place the gaze over the right shoulder if you're wanting a little bit more of a twist. We're not engaging any muscles here. Just finding a nice gentle twist. Releasing all that we just did. We'll come back to center one final time. Pull the knees into the chest. Wrap the arms around the shins and pull the nose in towards the knees. So just curl up into a tight little ball. Come as tight as you can here. Engaging every little muscle, pulling it all in for one more inhale. Pause at the top of the inhale. So hold that breath in. Take one more little sip of air. Exhale, open up to your Shavasana. Well deserved, right? A lot of work here in your Shavasana. Give yourself permission to let go, to enjoy these last few moments on your mat in stillness and rest. And I'll call you back when it's time. Thank you.
slowly allow your awareness to return to your body. Notice if you benefit from a few more moments in your Shavasana. You're more than welcome to stay and rest as long as it serves you. If you're ready to reawaken, to restart your day, start to find soft movements back into fingers and toes. Taking those movements up into the arms and the legs. Reach the arms long above you to the full body stretch. Point the toes, lengthen it all out. And the knees come into the chest, roll onto either side for a fetal position. Use your bicep as a pillow for the head. And then finding your way up to a comfortable seat in your own time. Sitting up, crossing the legs, hands come to heart center. You can close the eyes or find a soft gaze down towards the ground. Release all the air out of your lungs. Take a deep breath and fill it all back up. Open up, clear it out. And then show yourself some gratitude here for taking time out of your day to show up on your mat, for taking time out of your practice, and most importantly, for taking some time for you, especially with how the world is right now, a little bit stressful. Maybe a lot of you are stuck at home. It's really good to take a moment to let go. And show gratitude to all those practicing with you, even if it's from another state, another house. And I'm grateful that you all came and joined me in this practice. From my heart to each and every one of yours, namaste. Thanks guys for joining me. Please leave a comment on how you liked it, any questions or anything like that for future ones or any requests. I'm always open to requests. If there's something that you'd like to work on in your practice that you would like for me to include in a class, I would love to do that for you. And our next planned Facebook Live class is going to be this Sunday. It's gonna be at 10:45 a.m. with a wonderful Michelle. She's gonna be doing a 60-minute all levels vinyasa class. So it'll be a little bit slower than this if you felt like this was a little bit fast for you. It's gonna slow it down just a little bit from our power class. It'll still be all levels, so lots of options for everyone. But thank you for joining us with Shangri-La Hot Yoga and me in your practice. And I hope to see you again soon. Have a wonderful evening.